guys doing? Happy Wednesday. Sam Fatsuomanu back again, this time downstairs in the dungeon with another video. Not a rant video, not one to start or end the video with. I know you guys are disappointed you wanted another rant video, but hopefully that's all done with. We just got back a little while ago. We were out as a family doing some shopping, and we stopped by our local Desert Industries. Bought a few things. Really nothing as far as gaming goes. Nothing new. That Atari 800 home computer is still there. I mean, I think it's still $75. Not really, you know, itching to buy it anytime soon, but it was still there. But of course, I bet that if I finally decide to go ahead and jump and take a chance at it, more than likely it'll be gone. But who cares? I mean, I don't really know anything about it. But that's not what this video is about. This video is about a couple things I did pick up from Desert Industries. Also, I want to show you a few things I picked up last night, Tuesday night, at Best Buy. So, yeah, without further ado, let me go ahead and get set up and show you everything, alright? Alright, so first few things I want to show you are from last night, Tuesday night, a few pickups of mine from Best Buy. I went there looking for maybe a game or a movie or both. I ended up finding and just buying a couple of movies. I did not find any other games that really interested me. Nothing really new came out that I had my eye on, because I ended up passing the order 1886 this past Sunday. I bought it Friday afternoon. I didn't play it until late Saturday night, and I played it again Sunday night and ended up passing it. didn't expect it to be that short of a game, but I still loved it nonetheless. I really enjoyed playing that game. I recommend it if you have it on your radar and you haven't bought it yet. Badass graphics, you know, especially if you have like a next gen console. I have it for my PS4, and the graphics are pretty damn badass. Gameplay is good, really good. Story is really good. And that's why I wasn't really disappointed when it ended. It kind of caught me off guard when it ended, you know, but like I said, I wasn't disappointed because there's so much of the story that still has to take place. And unlike other games where they try to plan the sequel according to the ending of the first part, and it's like it really doesn't make any sense, or it's just really crappy. That was not the case for this game, at least to me. I really enjoyed it. Looking forward to when the new one comes out, you know, because there is going to be a sequel. I don't want to give it away or spoil it for you, but if you haven't played it, but I recommend it, you know, if you have it on your radar and if you are really thinking about whether or not to get it, pick it up. It's a really good game. But yeah, I didn't see any other game there. Funny thing is, I have a few games for my PS4 that I purchased a while back that are still sealed that I have yet to play, so how about playing those games, Sam? Yeah, I probably should, right? Instead of wasting money, keep buying new games and not even playing half of them. But I picked up a few movies from Best Buy. And I've been coming across a lot of movies, and I've been purchasing more here and there, thrift store, Best Buy recently. But yeah, I mean, ones that I like. And this one, this first one I want to show you is a double DVD box set. That's for the Lego Movie and Lego Batman the Movie. And yes, I know this is empty, but it's right here. The Lego guy that comes with it. My son wanted to play with it, of course, but of course, 2 minutes into playing with it, he forgot about it. But yeah, I wanted to watch the Lego Movie because I didn't watch it when it came out. Me and the wife, I believe, like we both wanted to make a date night and go and watch this. It looked really fun. But I think something came up and we weren't able to go. So when I saw this, I think this was, I'm not sure if it was like 17 something or 14 something. I can't remember. But I picked it up and we watched the movie as a family that Tuesday night. Because we didn't have cable or internet. I wonder why, Comcast. But anyways, we watched it. We enjoyed it. I liked it, you know. So I picked this up, the Lego Movie and the Batman, and the Lego Batman the Movie. DVD box set with this little Lego Movie Guy keychain. Alright, so the next one up, I got three more. The last three are Blu-ray movies. And this first one, I'm really happy I found it. At first, I thought it was something that I had already watched. I haven't watched too many of, like, a lot of the series for this. I think I've only seen one, like, last year or a year before on Netflix. So I was a little hesitant because I didn't want to watch it all over again, although I didn't remember because it was so long ago. But I watched it last night, and it wasn't the same one, but... I was really happy I got it because this is pretty badass, and this is something for all you anime fans, which I am one, you know. And that is Appleseed Alpha. This was really badass. This was seven. They had it in like the 780 something, 88, $8 something movie section. But Appleseed Alpha, really badass animated. Cartoon, movie, whatever the hell you want to call it. There is it right there. Animation is really, really badass. I really enjoyed this. I wish it could have been a little longer. It wasn't super short, but you know, it could have been a little longer. But you know, these come out every now and then, I guess. So, looking forward for the latest one. I assume this was the latest one. I might be wrong, you know. I've only seen one other one, like I said, and that was like a long ass time ago. But Appleseed Alpha Blu-ray disc, that's like 8 something, 7 something, I can't remember. The next one I bought is a movie that I also wanted to watch on the theater, but this is one that I don't think my wife wanted to watch with me. And that is the Planet of the Apes, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. This is also a Blu-ray one. I remember seeing the previews for this. I forgot what movie we were watching, but I wanted to watch. You know, I wanted to watch it, and I kind of like a few of them, not all of them, but I haven't watched this yet. I'll probably, when everyone goes to bed, maybe watch this one or the next one I'm about to show you. But got this. I think this was like 14 something or 17 something, but another Blu-ray, blah blah blah. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. If you guys have seen this, let me know if you guys liked it. More than likely, by the time you comment, I would either have already watched it or will be in the process of watching it. But glad to pick it up nonetheless. And the last one is one that I'm really happy I found, and I think it just not too long ago came out, because it wasn't that long ago when it was on theater, in the theaters. And it's another movie that my wife didn't want to go and watch with me, and all my other family and friends, their schedules just didn't allow them to come out, so there's no way in hell I was gonna go by myself. But this movie is Brad Pitt and the Fury. I love me some war movies, and this looked really, really good. I heard a lot of good things about it. I have yet to watch this. I might watch this or the Planet of the Apes tonight, and then of course watch the other one another night. But really happy to add this to my little collection. Blu-ray, The Fury. And and that's it from Best Buy. Those four movies, the double set box, or double DVD box set, the Lego Movie with Batman, the Lego Movie, and then these three right here. And I believe he was $17.99. Again, I could be wrong. I can't remember. I don't know where my receipt is. I probably threw it away. But those are my pickups from last night, Tuesday night at Best Buy. Now let me show you what I picked up earlier today from Deseret Industries. All right, so hang on. You know what? Before I show you that, let me show you really quick. You remember that caution zombie crossing sign that I picked up a couple days ago from Savers? I think it was last week Friday. Yeah, it was on me and my wife's date night, and I wanted to get a frame for it. I couldn't find any frames at Michael's. I haven't come across any while dumpster diving, any that were intact enough for me to use them. So I just went to the thrift store. And you could do that if you are like me, if you like to have your posters framed, or if you dumpster dive at GameStop and you find some stuff and you cut them out. You know, if you don't find any frames from other places that you dumpster dive, like stores like Michael's or whatever, just go to the thrift store. They're pretty cheap. And I bought this frame from Desert Industries today for $2, and it fit perfectly. So there it is, all framed up, looking nice and sexy and pretty. Zombie, or caution, zombie X-ing. So this is definitely going to go up here in the dungeon. Nice little score. And yeah, turned out pretty good. All right, so let me show you right now my pickups from Desert Industries, all right? All right, so like I said earlier, nothing really as far as games earlier tonight, you know, for Desert Industries. All I did was pick up a few movies and some other things that I'll just show you in just a little bit. The two movies I picked up was this first one with Marilyn Monroe and I don't know how you say his first name. It has Tony Randall and Frankie Vaughn. Again, these are way before my time, but I just like these old movies, like from the 50s, the 60s, the 40s, even the 20s, you know. Some people might think that I'm weird because that was like way before my time, but I like them. I've never seen this one, but I went ahead and bought it for $2. It's like, let's make love. Bow, chicka, bow, bow. So yeah, it's like a cool movie. Back right there. This is $2. Try to make time to check this bad boy out. And then the other one I bought is still factory sealed, and it's a deluxe edition, and that is, stupid price tag is in the way, but it's a deluxe edition for The Mask of Zorro for $2 as well. As you can see, still factory sealed. And that's the only reason why I bought it. I know people might think that's weird, but you know, people do that, they buy sealed stuff. But yeah, $2 for that. I kind of liked it. The Zorro, the first one was okay. Alright, so the last thing I picked up, actually there are two more things. One of them I'll just show you a picture, because it's a little too big. Well, I could probably show you, but I was just too lazy. I took a picture of it, and I'll just show you the picture of it, you know, in the video, and it's upstairs. But one of the last two things that I picked up, I found this for $2, a Mario Kart Wii bed tent, and I haven't even looked in it yet. It says comes with the flashlight here. I'm hoping it's still there, because a lot of times stuff like this, especially if it gets donated, you know, it's not all there. I might try to put it together. I'm not sure if I have enough room here, maybe upstairs, or yeah, I'll see, and I'll, you know, take a picture of it and add it to this video if in fact it is complete. If you don't see a picture of it, then that just means it's not all there. But I couldn't pass it up. You know, Mario's right there for $2. Mario Kart Wii bed tent. And apparently with a free flashlight. I have yet to see. And the other thing, I'll just tell you what it is. And you'll see it in the video as a picture. It's this, it's still in the carrying case thing. It's a kid's telescope and microscope for $4, and it was something that I think it said from Lowe's or Best Buy, can't remember, but you'll see it. And that's basically it, guys. Quick little trip into a DI. I got excited because there wasn't like a ton of people there, and sometimes that's like a good thing, sometimes it just doesn't mean anything at all. This was one of those nights where it didn't mean jack, you know, because there still wasn't anything good there or anything good coming out. So hopefully the next time around I'll find some games or something gaming related that's really cool to show you guys. But that's it. that's a wrap as far as what I've got to show you. Again, if you don't see that picture of the tent in the video, that just means that it wasn't all in the box, you know. I'll look it over off camera, and if it is all there, I'll put it together, show you guys. Hopefully it's all there, and I'll show you a picture of the microscope, kids telescope microscope thing. That's it, you guys. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, let me know what you think. Check out my other videos. My one I just uploaded is out there already, the Comcast rant. If you had no idea what I was talking about earlier, if I even mentioned anything about a rant earlier, but now you know. But that's it, guys. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.